All right, welcome back. Here we have an unkeepable hand. Let's throw this back. Here we have a reasonable hand. We're gonna take a bunch of damage off our Thoughtseizes, but we're gonna still play one on turn one. And then probably one on turn two. Depends on what he does. Oh, he's aggro. I mean, we'll probably save more damage from taking his only two drop if we get lucky than doing anything else here. Like, we could take this. And he has to play this guy that he's out of gas. I guess it's not the worst. We gotta get this courser into play stat though. What is go? There we go. Ooh, ultimate price. It's probably just better to kill this guy, take one, and then courser come down a turn later. I'll wait to see if he has a creature to play pre-combat. Down to 12, which is not a great number to be at. But he's completely out of gas. Bottom that, obviously. He ripped something? He's got something. That is a big thing. Alright. I'm gonna keep that on top. Locks down his Gore Clan. That was a 3-2 or a 3-3, 3-3. I do have one awkward thing. If he attacks both of his guys at my Kiora, I either have to let Kiora die or I have to block here. Ooh, that's a big one. I'm dead. Alright, weird deck. It's like three color aggro, Jund aggro. This didn't seem great against him, but it does stop his most aggressive draw. Huh. This seemed mediocre. This seemed like it could be reasonable. Saw at least two things of hits that are good. Definitely don't need this. Probably don't need this either. Do I want to bring in the ultimate price? I'm not sure. Probably want to bring this in, to be honest. For maybe one Thoughtseize. Alright, let's give that a shot. I'm not sure about the Aetherling probably needs to be in this deck, actually. Maybe I just take out one more Thoughtseize. Feels like a card I want to draw one of. Sure, let's give this a shot. Woo.